mean, let's say I also been overweight 6 to 8 months ago. If
Oh,
you've been
really?
following me on Facebook, I posted the picture, yeah.
Okay.
And I was looking fat. The weight was not that big, but I was looking fat. And I hired one health and fitness expert, and he became my health coach, and he taught me how to eat, what to eat. And for the very first time in my life, I thought that I was eating like crap. I was eating garbage. And that changed my perspective. And I shared the photos with you, and I lost only 4 kilo, but I was looking so slim.
Right.
And at that time, when I first started, I started following intermittent fasting. If you don't know intermittent fasting, intermittent is
Right.
like you only eat for 8 hours a day or
Right.
less than 8 hours a day. So I decided not to eat anything before afternoon 12. So I never actually leave without a big cup of tea in the morning.
All right.
And if you know, the Indian tea is full of sugar.
That's
It's
right.
creamy,
Definitely.
right? So I used to have 2 big cups of tea before 12. I used to eat, snacks and everything, because I'm coming from the city called Surat
Right.
in the western part of India, and they are known for eating snacks every single morning. I used to eat like that. And then I realized I need to stop doing it at once.
Right.
So for the next day, I said, I'm not going to eat anything before 12. And my family members could not believe. They said, what are you going to drink in the morning then? I said, black coffee with no sugar. They said, that's not possible, because I used to eat sweets a lot. If you put the box of sweets and cakes, I'm the first one. I was the first one to grab it.
All right.
And I said, I'll stop doing it. They say, that's not possible. I said, no, it is going to be possible. And I actually implemented. And I don't know if you call it the willpower or just discipline. I said, from the next day, I'm not going to eat anything before 12. I'm going to drink only black coffee, no sugar, no sweet.
All right.
And in just 2.5 months' time, I became so slim.
Right.
Right? And I don't know, but if you decide to do something, then you need to take the required action. Now, if you understand the word required action, it's not just the word. It's a required action means the things that you need to do in order to come to conclusion, in order to get the result.
Right.
And this is the big thing. This is the big thing. Taking required action is the necessary tool to get the outcome that you want. For example, if you need to grow your business, what do you need to do? You need to approach more people. You need to talk to more people. You got to sell more consistently every single day. You can't just approach 5 people and say, oh, boom, I've done it. I've done the job. You got to do it consistently. You got to deliver the result.
Right.
You got to deliver the service, the operations, and everything. Complete the process. These are the required action. And people don't understand the meaning of required action.
Right.
And what I need to tell about Dave Goggins is he took required action
Right. That's right.
to achieve this.
Yeah, see, coming back to the point where you had a nutritionist in place, a fitness expert in place, I myself have actually faced a lot of problems with my body weight. I used to box at 185 pounds, and I'm actually around, I walk around at 220 pounds these days. So it's like overweight. But what I have found is that even if I work out, I'm not able to decrease my weight. I'm not able to lose my weight while I'm working, while I'm traveling a lot. The stress actually gets to you. I don't eat too much every day. I mean, I will have 2 meals a day. So 1 meal in the morning and the other meal at night, whenever I come back to home, whenever I get free from the office. And I think that unpreparedness and that irregularity in your meals, that also increases the weight of your body, because your body cannot comprehend basically the nutrition that it is getting. So your body will actually store much more of fat in your body. I mean, the metabolism completely goes up and down. Just to give you example, right now in the lockdown, this crazy lockdown, I have lost around 12 pounds in
Good
just
man. Good for you.
in last 10 days. I have lost 12 pounds, and I'm doing very light workout. That's all I'm doing right now.
Yeah.
I'm just building up, and that's what I'm trying to do. I need to go another 20 pounds on this before I will rest on this. But yeah, I mean, for a lot of people, the sweet tooth is a problem, just like you had one. But You being a Gujarati, it's completely fine. I mean, there are so many Gujaratis who are into sweets. So yeah, I mean, that's fine. But again, a little bit of workout will help you not get your body too loose, because a lot of things start to hang out once you increase 2 or 3 kilos or 4 kgs of weight in your body. Because you are not working regularly, because you are not doing any cardio, maybe you are not going to gym and putting lifting weights, things actually pop out and they start to hang. And that's when you look actually bad. And it is bad for your mental side as well, because it gives you a lack of confidence again that about yourself while you are talking to people, how to represent yourself. There is so much body shaming going around that people actually are conscious about that as well. But you don't come to me, come across as a person who would be actually worried about body shaming. So I'm pretty sure that you did it because you were aware of the problems that you can face in the future.
I'm not an expert on nutrition, but I need to tell you what I learned from my health coach. You know, his name is Gunman Sharma,
right?
And he's a great coach. And for the very first time, I realized that looking overweight is really shameful. Sorry to say that.
Mm-hmm.
It's really shameful.
Right.
Because it actually means that you don't care for your body.
Absolutely agree.
Because your existence is because of your body.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can't ignore the body that you are holding. Mm-hmm. You can't ignore the structure. Mm-hmm. You know, because it affects all things around you. And the thing is, let's say it's good to eat, you know, in Gujarati culture or whatever. It is not good to eat everything. This is our body. It needs some fuel,
right,
to run.
Right.
Just like your vehicle needs a petrol and a good quality petrol to run effectively, the same way your body requires some fuel,
mm-hmm,
to run it effectively.
Right.
And if you put the garbage in, though, obviously the body is not going to digest those things.
Right.
It was stored as a fat, and it's not really good. I mean, I did not even realize. I mean, I realized at it very recent age, by the way, only a year ago or something, right, less than a year ago. Right. But till then, I'd done a lot of damage to my body.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Even if you do a lot of workout, but if you don't have the right food habit, you're not going to do anything. So the thing is how we started. Let me tell you, my wife kept pushing me. You know, a year ago when I was overweight, she kept pushing me to go out for a walk.
Mm-hmm.
She said, go to Jogger's Park, do a jogging, walking, blah, blah, blah. You look ugly. Right. You look like a balloon. And I,
that's your wife? I said, are you sure?
Yeah, my wife. Yeah, definitely. Because she's slim and she doesn't want to, you know, she doesn't want to be embarrassed by seeing around me. Right, because I was looking like a balloon, and she said, "Go to a walk, or go for a walk every day." She kept pushing me and everything. You know how the wife speaks and everything. You know, you can imagine.
Oh, that's harsh.
But that's really harsh. So what happened? Okay, no problem. I was not too determined, to be honest. I was not too determined to lose my weight at that time. She said, "You look balloon. You gotta go." And I can't believe. Sorry, come on. This is who I am.
Right.
So I went to those Jogger's Park, if you know around. Mm-hmm. So I went there every day for about 10 days or something.
Right.
I used to walk one round, two rounds. And I'm quite outgoing person. I started chatting with people.
Right.
Right. So I talked to some people and I asked them, I said, for how long you've been walking? And they say, oh, I've been walking for the last 5 years, 10 years, 2 years. And I looked at them and I thought, you are still a balloon.
Right. That's the point I was going to ask you.
Absolutely. They say, oh, I walk four rounds or five rounds every day. I say, you're still not in the good shape. What's wrong with you?
Right.
I did not tell them upfront. But I say to my wife, I say, I'm not going for a walk. It doesn't make any difference.
Right.
It wastes my time.
Mm-hmm.
It's just my energy. I look at those people who are walking for the last 5 years. They're not making any difference in their life. Mm-hmm. The only thing that makes a difference is that they feel good because they get a fresh air.
Right.
But it doesn't help you to lose weight.
Right.
So then I approached my friend who's a health coach. As I said earlier, he explained to me how the body works.
Right. Right.
Right. And he introduced me to the concept called intermittent fasting. And I used to eat four times a day. Then I started eating 2 times a day.
Right.
And that made a huge difference.
Right.
Right. So we got to follow. I mean, I'm not a fitness expert, so obviously I'm not the best person to advise you, but something has to be done because it affects your, I mean, your self-esteem as well. It affects your stamina. It affects your thinking. If you don't care for your health, I mean, you don't care for anything else.
Right.
It's a reflection.
Right.
It's a reflection. Yeah. Health, so I'm not saying that you stop walking.
No.
Yeah.
Not like that. I mean, see, people walk. You have struck gold with the person who actually gave you this advice that you need to first and foremost clean up your nutrition, because I totally understand and I totally agree with that. There are so many people in our society who are using a ketogenic diet, which is basically eating anything other than carbs. That's what sugar and carbs. That's the two things that you have to cut out of your nutrition. And then they are reducing their weight. Then they are coming back on the carbs and they are ballooning even furthermore. The reason being that they are not educated enough on the nutrition part. They will go on Google. They will actually read what is a ketogenic diet and they will just start. Basically, ketogenic diet is making your body learn how to not use carbs and use fats. How to process fats as a fuel to run the body. So basically, you are eating chicken and other various protein-based food, and you are eating that, and then you are leaving it. So if you are leaving it, it's not going to be any use for you, because as soon as you get back on carb, your body will respond like, "Oh boy, this person actually starved me last time, so I'm going to store even more this time." So the fats actually increase in your body when you come back on carb, and if you cannot get back on carbs, just control the carbs that you are taking. You don't need to go for ketogenic diet. I mean, so there are so many dynamics to this thing. I mean, being a sports person, I have known just about everything, especially in boxing. We used to cut weight. So we used to cut around 4 kgs of weight in the last six or seven hours before the fight, because we need to make weight for the competition, right? We need to make the qualification weight. So we have gone through everything in this. One more point that I would make is people work out every day and then measure their weight. So when they are measuring their weight, they are getting a sense of the weight is reducing because they are actually cutting down the water weight in your body. Your body has a lot of water in it. And when you exercise and you work out, basically you are cutting that weight. You are not cutting the fats or anything like those. I mean, the things that you need to reduce in your body, basically that is not going down. And you are just reducing the water weight and you are being happy.